Got a quick question for you. During your open water training, was your instructor getting fed up with you because you wasn't learning the information as quick as your fellow students? Well, guess what? 9 out of 10 times, it's not your fault, but the instructor's fault. What's up, guys? It's Brian again from Lake Hickory Scuba Marina. If you are new to our channel, I just want to say, hey, welcome to us. I really hope you enjoyed today's video. And if you do enjoy it, do me a favor. Maybe consider hitting that subscribe button over here and make sure you click that little bell as well. That way you will be notified each and every time we upload a new video. If you are a returning subscriber, I just want to say thank you for joining us again. And I really hope you enjoy today's topic. What we're going to get into today is what's called instructor burnout. Now, instructor burnout happens to all instructors on some level. So whether or not you get sick and tired of teaching the same classes over, or maybe you get sick and tired of maybe always diving the same places over, or maybe you just get sick and tired of the shop that you work for, it happens to all of us. I know personally I've experienced this several times throughout my career. So what I thought I would do is give you a top 5 video on how to prevent it and how to come out of it. So we're going to take an in-depth look on some examples of instructor burnout, and then I'll show you exactly how you can, first of all, prevent it from ever happening. But if it does, I'll teach you how to come back out of it so that you can still enjoy being a dive professional. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, guys, so I want to give you a quick example of instructor burnout and what it can look like, and then I'll kind of go into ways that you can prevent it and how to bring yourself out of it if you ever experience this. So a great example of this happened to me a couple of years back. I had a student who came in, signed up for class. We were basically going through his open water program, and after about a couple of weeks, his days of coming in started getting very sporadic. So he would come in like 2 days this week, 2 days next week, and then I didn't see him for over a month. And I'd call him up and say, hey, do you want to come in, complete your classroom, complete your pool work? And he's like, yeah, I'll come in a couple days next week or something. And he, of course, never showed up again. And so eventually, after about a 6-month time frame, he had only completed about 3 chapters of his open water program. He had only went to 2 pool sessions, and we just never got him completed. After a time frame of 6 months, he just never completed his course. So what I did was I called him up and I said, hey, this is so-and-so at the dive shop. I said, are you still interested in completing your certification? And he's like, yeah, I just got to find the time to it. Now, a little more backstory real quick was the kid was young. He was very smart. He was athletic, so there was no academic or physical thing that was preventing him. It was just a lack of motivation on his part. And to be honest with you, after 6 months, I kind of gave up on him, and I'm like, hey, fine, you paid me all this money. If you want to lose that investment, that's fine. You don't have to complete it. And typically from a business standpoint, that's usually how it goes. People pay us money to train them to do something. And the reason that they don't get certified is either one, they get incompletes, or they fail the academics and they don't want to take it over, or they just simply cannot do it. It's just not for them. Or they give up on themselves. And that's basically what he had done. Well, I'd kind of done the same thing. I gave up on to him as well. Instead of calling him and saying, hey, are you sure this is what you want to do? What I probably should have done was gave him that extra bit of motivation, or asked him questions such as, well, what can we do to make it easier for you to stay motivated? Can we do a couple more pool sessions with you? Do you want to try on a couple of different types of gear? Can I take you to a different setting to do your training? And I should have really took the role as that role model, if you will, as a professional, and motivated him to come back in. Because I really think that he wanted to do it, I just think he wasn't motivated enough. So due to my instructor burnout towards him of just not being motivated himself, I pretty much gave up on him. Now, no, I can't force a person to come in and complete their course, but I think this particular student is in general, I could have done a lot more to get him to come back in. So that's kind of a low-end example of what instructor burnout is. A high-end example is just when you get so sick and tired of teaching the same thing over and over and over, not only do you give up being an instructor, you just get out of the industry as a whole. You quit being an instructor. And I've actually seen that happen with several instructors, especially in my past. So what I'm going to do right now is give you the top 5 ways that you can either, one, prevent instructor burnout, or number 2, how you can bring yourself out of it so that you can be the best educator possible, not only for yourself, but also more importantly for your students. Number 5. So probably one of the best ways to prevent instructor burnout is to make sure you're getting started on the right foot, if you will. Make sure you're getting into this industry for the right reasons. If you're wanting to become a dive professional, you need to understand what being a dive professional is all about. Maybe you need a good mentor that's going to walk you through the process or show you how they've been successful over the years. And if you get started on the right foot, then you'll probably never really lose that drive or passion that got you into diving in the first place, and you'll be able to relay that to your students in the future. So always make sure you start in as a dive professional for the right reasons. Number four simply is go slow. If you happen to work for a training center where they may have 10 to 20 instructors and you're constantly battling to see how many students you can get, slow down. You don't have to be the instructor that has the highest student count. My suggestion to you is go slow, teach a few students here or there, and then as you teach those students, the less that you actually teach, the better quality of an instructor that you will be, and those students will actually come back and request to have you as an instructor, and you will slowly build up your student base. So once you become an instructor, you're not actually in a race to see how many students you can get, say in a year's time frame. Number three in short is stay educated, guys. Get out there and take as many classes as you possibly can. Take classes that you don't even think that you might be interested in, because you may spark an interest that you didn't even know you had. And the more experience that you get, that means as an instructor, that's the more classes that you can actually teach. And if you can teach a multitude of classes, then you're not going to get burned out just teaching that same class over and over and over and over. So get educated. It's going to make you a safer, more comfortable, and more confident diver, and you can relay that to your students, making them, of course, a safer, more comfortable, and a more confident diver as well. Number two is probably one of my favorite ways to actually prevent instructor burnout, and all you've got to do is be a mentor. Be a mentor to younger divers, be a mentor to newer dive professionals, and as a mentor, not only are you teaching someone, but you're help guiding them into becoming a mentor themselves. One of the greatest feelings I've had as an instructor is taking a non-diver, bringing them all the way up through the ranks, and making them a dive instructor, and then a couple years later, actually taking a class from them and seeing them teach and seeing myself in them. That's one of the greatest feelings I think I've ever had as a dive professional. And in short, I was a mentor to them, and now they can go out and be a mentor to others as well. And that in itself keeps me motivated and keeps me excited about being a dive professional. And I can promise you, one of the best ways to prevent instructor burnout. The number one way to prevent instructor burnout, and it's probably the hardest way to prevent it, but I promise you it works every time, is take a day off. Don't teach tomorrow. Don't teach the next day. Take a day off. Enjoy life. Get out there with your friends, your family, your spouse, your kids, and enjoy your family time, or hang out with some friends. Go bowling. Go shooting. Go do whatever it is that you enjoy to do, just because you need to take a day off to relax. If you followed steps 5, 4, 3, 2, and especially number 2, if you've mentored somebody up where they really need to be, then let them take the reins. Let a lesser experienced instructor take over for a day and you take the day off. If you train that instructor right, then you know that you can trust your students with them. Take a day off, enjoy life, and I promise you, instructor burnout won't even be part of your vocabulary. But guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it's helpful for all new instructors or even experienced instructors out there that are currently experiencing instructor burnout. Follow these 5 tips, and I promise you, it will rejuvenate you as an instructor. It will pick your enthusiasm back up, and you will be a much better instructor for it. But guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, smash that like button for me. Definitely share it as well. Guys, as always, make sure you follow us on Instagram and Twitter. Like us on Facebook. Pin us on Pinterest. Subscribe to us here on YouTube. And as always, guys, we appreciate your business.